that. Oh wait, can we use that?
Is that usable?
Was that?
I thought it was okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay. Kalei didn't even know that song.
And I'm probably going to forget it tomorrow.
You probably forgot it.
I probably already forgot it. I think I can remember at least half of it.
Nice song, though, yeah?
It is. Like, the recording is really cool, especially with all the string sections in there.
Well, I thought you guys did a beautiful version. That's The Rain by Joe Hisaishi.
Thank you. That was Andrew's recommendation.
Beautiful
song. Forgot about that song. Love that song.
You did good, Kalei.
Thank you.
Kalei spent the last hour just...
It's not really like just remembering how the melody goes. It's like you gotta get to know the song. That way you can kind of like... I don't know. I think the music should come out
like immediately.
Naturally.
That was beautiful.
Oh,
he's such a genius composer.
Well, yeah, I wish I could write songs like that.
So you how he takes that, it's the typical like East Asian, I don't know, is it East Asian chord progression?
Yeah, it's kind of like,
but makes it better.
What would you call an East Asian chord progression?
So you would do that kind of.
With it is just what?
But you think that's more in Asian pop that sort of
that's like one of the most recycled chord progressions in there. The think of like five Japanese songs.
What is that movement in terms of like it's like the
6 mm-hmm. 4
5 1
yep. There's you could even just like 1 4 5 because 6 is relative to 1.
You know what song does that
a lot? So we got a lot of instruments to show you guys tonight. Yes. And let's get into it. Kalei, start us off. Talk about what you got.
All right. So I have one of my favorite models from Ko'olau. This is the T100. It's not anything super flashy, but it's a really amazing instrument because these are still built the same way by Noah himself. And amazing work. I would say we only get a few of these a year, and normally when we do, they sell pretty quickly because of the awesome reputation that Ko'olau has and the quality of instruments that they produce. This is all Hawaiian koa for the top, back, and sides. And oh, I really like this koa rosette here, right next to the sound hole. And it has some really nice purfling. We got rosewood faceplate on the headstock, as well as ebony for the fretboard and bridge. Mahogany neck. And we got Goto tuners here. These are some of the best. Don't let the simple look fool you. They're very smooth, very reliable, and can't get enough of them. So so let's give this ukulele a sound sample.
So, you know what? Like, I think these are still only going for $2,000.
And, what? Yeah. I thought there would have been a price increase by now. Wow, good.
Maybe next time. But Corey's got a Pono guitar that we haven't actually sampled before, which was like really surprising for me. I guess we had the cedar top version of it and the cutaway version of it. But yeah, talk about this guy.
This is the OM10 S for spruce top. And we've had the OM model for quite a long time, a few years now. This is offered also in mahogany with cedar and rosewood and spruce, and also limited in rosewood and cedar. Anyways, this is the spruce and acacia version. Beautiful acacia back and sides with ebony binding top and back. Same ebony is on the bridge fretboard faceplate. I have a capo on here. These come with 80/20 bronze strings, so if you'd like to do a lot of bluegrass music, this works really well. This is a very good bluegrass guitar.
You didn't give us a sound sample with a capo at the like 7th fret or something?
I mean, maybe I should.
No, you gotta play the full spec.
So...
Cause you only need the light when it's burning low.
So you got rosewood on the bridge.
It's gonna be such a weird sound self-description.
They'd be like, oh, I love passenger. Love the passenger. Anyways, gloss body, satin neck. The neck is mahogany. Nice heel cap here that is an ebony, a little bit darker than the rest of the ebony. Grover stay tight tuners, 18:1, very smooth, very easy to use. Let's give it a good sound sample.
What's the name of that song?
Since We Met.
Engelmann spruce has a bit of a warmer sound than other spruces. It's It's quite nice.
It's really earthy sounding. Like
nice.
It's really.
It sounds like it's from the earth.
It was. It actually came out of the earth.
Technically. All right. Wood is from the earth.
It's Earth Engelmann.
Okay, we got a bunch of great yeast tonight, so we're gonna swap over to a few more.
Yeah, but doesn't this have like this nice drive to it? Usually, spruce kind of has like a, it's bright and clear, but this one is just like it's
a little bit grungy. Yeah, it has a punchy. Like, mm-hmm. Yeah, it has a nice punchy mid.
It's like getting yelled at, but. It's very nice. You're getting yelled at, but they're saying compliments. They're yelling compliments at you.
It's a nice.
You're great. Oh, thanks.
Oh, thank you.
Amazing. Now I'm flustered in a good way.
You're not supposed to do that to women on the street, Corey.
What? Ooh, come down to Motel 6. Guess if your bed was washed.
It's a rare sighting. It's a pineapple cola.
Full on soprano, too.
Dang. Long neck?
Not even, I don't think.
Whoa. Oh, wow.
Oh, that's rare. Looks like,
wow.
Feel like I should turn the volume
down. I know. Speakers clipping. this is loud. Like look how gentle I'm strumming. Like I'm even strumming up here.
Young boys, turn that down.
Is that a pineapple?
y'all's Hawaiian music. Turn that down.
Right, so we got this very rare sighting of a Ko'olau pineapple soprano ukulele. It's already hard enough to find a Ko'olau pineapple, but finding one with this amount of beautiful koa on it is even harder. Very, very beautiful. Really nice nitrile finish we got going on here. Master grade koa, beautiful work. We got abalone for the rosette, ebony bridge, fingerboard, and faceplate as well. Ko'olau logo inlaid in mother of pearl, black and gold UPT tuners from Goto, and a very massive sound for a little pineapple ukulele. Wow. It's like you can tell how much sound this thing puts off just by strumming it over here. Normally you don't, but just by me moving it towards the sound hole, you can actually see how much tone comes out from this. Thank you. Dang. Wow. Fun that's, ukulele.
That's a massive sound.
Pretty incredible new custom.
Yeah, and this features a top, back, and sides that you rarely find made out of an instrument made out of like this type of wood. I mean, we have a very beautiful custom Kennard tenor ukulele, and this features Coco Bowl for the top, back, and sides, but commonly, you'll see Coco Bolo used for just the back and sides, and it has a lot to do with the density of the wood, but it's really interesting because when you put any type of wood in the right luthier's hands, you're going to get a very incredible result. And this is a very good example of being, you know, trying to go against the grain as far as like what a building standard is. And we've gotten a lot of canards that came in the past, and this is the first one that I'm actually trying out, made out of full coco bolo for the top back and sides. Very beautiful. I love the rosette here. You can see that the coco bolo theme continues, and it's actually separated by little purfling lines here to make more of like a mosaic type of style rosette. Very, very beautiful. And then if you turn the ukulele around, you'll see the side port with coco bolo binding and purfling.
It's maple purfling too, yeah.
Maple purfling. Oh, nice. And then when you turn it in the back, you have the binding and the purfling continuing down the center around the body, but also it's really cool how they utilize the sap wood over here. There's a little bit of sap coming down the center, and it almost looks like the center strip just blends right into the sapwood. It looks like it was part of the whole two-piece back. But yeah, it's separate. Really cool. We have ebony bridge fingerboard faceplate, along with the signature canard headstock. And it looks to be a satin mahogany neck with gold tool UPTs, and I always thought it's really cool with this headstock because it allows you to install the tuners more of like a angle. Really cool, really impressed.
And the strings like are straight.
Oh yeah, that's true.
So yeah.
So you get like nothing pulling at the wrong angle. It's straight up, so you get the theory behind it is more sustained.
Yeah.
And also, there's a difference in tone, too. We've featured some ukuleles with this, and as well as some guitars, and it does make a difference.
What's surprising with this coco bolo is it doesn't seem like it's missing or it needs a softwood top, the way he built it.
Not at all. I mean, we were talking about earlier, I was like, remember asking you about, like, so with these like extra dense woods, that means you can, if you're going to use it for the whole body, you could cut the top like thinner than you normally
would
with a spruce or a cedar. But I wouldn't know. I have no clue like how thin or thick the top is. All I know is that it sounds good.
Well, when you're John S. Canard and you've been building guitars for 50 years, then you have a good idea of what, you know, you have to deal with wood and how to build for long-term stability and still give that sonic presence. It's it's an excellent instrument.
I don't know, let's take some time to admire the craftsmanship of this beautiful piece. That, what do we get, like a couple a year for?
Yeah,
for Lucky. I like the rosette a lot. On, you know, it's a dark rosette. Well, I mean, relatively dark compared to the rest of it, but it matches really well. Usually it's like a contrasting color, but
it's sweet how like the binding and the rosette all utilize coco bolo.
It is.
Which, can we just recognize the beautiful word that coco bolo is?
Is it the same? Sorry, my thank you.
get a sound sample of that yet?
No, not yet.
That was a sound sample in itself.
Solo, Corey. Solo sound sample.
Maybe play stuff I normally don't.
That's one way you can gauge how it's great, like, an ukulele is.
It, yeah,
it just changes, like, the way you play.
It's just like, whoa. What else can we do? You know,
kind of dark and bright at the same time, but you really hear every note so clearly.
Yeah, oh. And that's all Kokobolo.
It's almost like there's a built-in shimmering. It's like I hear like the. Almost like the frequency is almost like shaking.
Super unique, super special new canard. Corey has a...
Oh yeah, the ABC. 1, 2, 3. Which features a solid cedar top. Based off the Acacia Baritone Deluxe with the gloss finish. Here's the AB-C model. Acacia Baritone with a cedar top. So. Thank you.
Beautiful. Solid cedar, solid acacia, baritone. I put the Kolau Aho baritone set on that same model for you to compare.
Yes, I was thinking what this would sound like with fluorocarbon strings. So this is the AB-C with the Kolau fluorocarbon Aho string set. So. Reminds me a lot of a flamenco style guitar. It kind of has that act, that attack.
I just like the Aho baritone set for cutting the mud on baritones.
Okay,
when you want to, you know, it's not like you always want to, but if you want something that gives you that pristine note clarity. A few weeks ago, we got in some of these new Mau Loas, and we did some sound samples with their stock. I think it's the Dia Dario Pro Art set that comes on these. So I put a Kolau Aho fluorocarbon low G set on both this tenor and concert, if I could get samples from you guys and thoughts on these.
I have the TT55, which is the all mangro tenor. You have all the custom features, and I think with fluorocarbon, with just strings in general, it's very subjective. And the stock string set, I think it still sounds really good. I think they've even changed a little bit in the past batches that we had of Maloa. I think they're a little bit more open, a little bit more rich in tone, but with this, it is a bit of an upgrade, I think. It's not so much of like a lateral move where, you know, you could switch to Aquilas and you're like, oh, it's gives you the same kind of volume. It's just a different kind of response. With this, it's like, I mean, better clarity, better sustain.
It's like night and day.
Yeah.
It's just everything sounds more alive. I guess, like, this would be, like, a perfect pairing. It's like pairing your wine with your meal, you know? Strings with your ukulele.
Yeah.
Fluorocarbon, there's much more detail. So you hear more of the song, the instrument. But then also you hear a lot more mistakes, too, because it is brighter, it's gonna carry farther. Which, in the end, if you're trying to get better, that might be a good way to practice. Because the more mistakes you can hear, the more things you can work on, you know? I mean,
I like how it articulates my mistakes.
It does. I mean, like, for me, I notice it. I've been playing nylon strings for so long that, like, if I hit a buzz on a nylon string or in nylon set, you know, it's not as noticeable as a fluorocarbon.
Yeah.
For me.
Yeah, oh yeah, totally.
But all in all, it's a very pleasant, always a pleasant sound. But with these, you still maintain the true ukulele tone, which is which is nice.
Definitely. And flow carbon strings work to me really well if you're not gonna be like wailing on it the whole time, because it really showcases the overall tone and the sustain.
Well, it's cool. You can actually wail on these because they're not. Some fluorocarbons can be too bright and too harsh.
Yeah.
Where you're just strumming and it's just like.
But it depends on the instrument too, you know. Like some instruments are like kind of bright to begin with, and then you have to like, I don't know. The Mau Loas to me, it's like you're looking at this thing. And it looks like a full custom.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, at least from a distance. If you get into the details, like cosmetically, there's like little things that would say this is not $5,000 or $7,000 or something. But overall, it has that design and that whole vibe, you know?
Yeah, you got to appreciate
it. But when it, that. Yeah, I mean, it's freaking gorgeous. But when you get down to it, like sound-wise, they sound in the range of what you're buying. Like they sound like a $500 to $800 instrument, you know, but with the right setup and with the right string set, it's like it bumps it up even like a little bit more, and like you get more like $1,000 sounding instrument with like what looks to be like, I don't know, maybe thousands of dollars in, you know, custom work or whatever.
I mean, anybody would be happy to get one of these.
Oh yeah. Especially if like you realize how affordable and obtainable an ukulele like this is now. I mean, if you 10 years ago, I probably wouldn't imagine this.
With the features they have.
Yeah.
Just like all the inlays, a lot of headstock, all solid wood, and you know, the armrests and bevels, and it's like, what?
Pretty tricked out.
Yeah.
All right, Corey, give us a sample of this solid mango tenor.
The TC-31, this is the concert size, all solid wood, spruce top, rosewood back and sides, really cool armrest here on the bottom left bolt of the ukulele, gloss finish, satin mahogany neck, Mau Loa black and gold tuners. And they got the Mau Loa inlay on the headstock, as well as this really nice ocean palm tree swain paradise image here that they have on the fingerboard. And super affordable. This one has the Ko'olau Aho Lo G set. And it sounds really open now.
629 for that.
629.
As of 2022.
629. Wow.
I know first the solid spruce, solid rosewood, because rosewood is already tacking on quite a bit normally.
Yeah, that's insane.
I mean, we're the only ones with these, at least in America, so you're welcome. No, no, just joking. Just price things to sell, you know.
Christmas is right around the corner. Something like this would be an amazing gift. They're definitely going to remember it when they take it out of the case because of all the extras, the inlays. Just all these little details that you get for a super, very affordable price. Just over $600. So, yeah. There's a little something. Let's see if any of our viewers can guess this song.
Ooh, that ancient Chinese song.
Tuning. Oh.
I gotta say, it sounds pretty good with the low G on that concert.
Definitely. It's like... Wow.
That might be one of my favorite concerts under a grand.
It sounds pretty amazing.
Until you make the Master Series Pono concerts.
Oh! This is true.
Oh!
Okay.
The ACMS.
Yeah, you'll see that. So, that Pete Howlett you have, it's built with Carina wood. One way that's described as a warm tone similar to mahogany, but with a sweeter mid-range and obviously a bolder grain. It's an expensive wood, and it's rare.
I would have guessed like it was mango from.
Oh really?
if I didn't know, you know, yeah. It kind of
has that wild look, and some of those greener, you know, tones to it.
Carina,
yeah. So we had this uke, I don't know, 4 years ago or so, and it's back with us. The person that had it, I can say, has a collection of a bunch of amazing ukes and likes kind of cycling at a rotation.
I mean, it's like...
So it's cool that it's back on the market, and yeah, it's a really great tenor.
We get to play it again, too.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm all in.
I remember that one.
Pete Howlett is an amazingly talented builder from the UK that most people in the ukulele world know of. He was on the podcast some years ago. He has Parkinson's and has some challenges now in building, but manages to still be quite precise with everything because he cares a lot. And I don't know, he's a beautiful soul. And it comes out in his instruments.
I can hear it.
I agree.
I mean, it's like there's a lot of attack to each individual note. It just pops. And I was like mentioning earlier, like these are high tension strings that's on here, but it's so easy to play. It doesn't even feel like you gotta really press down. And then the neck, I noticed like it's shaped differently. Is it slightly more narrow? Because it feels like I could, like my hand kind of wraps around it a little bit more.
Yeah.
Which actually is probably the reason why I think it's easy to play. But yeah, here's a, let's go to sound sample.
Oh no, sound sample.
I had a hard time holding back because this is like the perfect sound for that song.
Yeah.
I was just like, I don't want to scratch it because there's like a muffling player. Right. Yeah.
This is the Rebel Invictus, and it's a custom grade instrument. This is an instrument that is very high in value because of what you get, and there's a variety of different woods on here. So starting with the top, this is one of my favorites, it's cedar, and there's if you focus on one area of the instrument, you'll see how intricate the design is. Like the bridge, there's so much going on here. You look at it, you're like, oh, that's nice. But when you really look at it, you're like, oh wow, there's it's not something you usually see. Same thing with the fretboard, the rosette, the wood combination. So you got cedar, you got the Thai myrtle on the sides, and you have ebony on the back, Panuk binding top and back, ebony bridge fretboard. You got Padauk on the bottom. This is like a blade at the bottom. Features a blade at the edge of the fretboard. That is a cutting edge technology. These are very lightweight in build, so that translates to a very light and airy sound. These are Joel's Uke Logic fluorocarbon strings. These are some of the best strings you can hear. Check it out.
Carbon sets that were lighter than what they have on it at the moment, and like it makes a big difference in terms of just that boldness. Yeah, and punch.
Like if you have like super high tension strings, you can do a really low setup too.
Yes,
and but that's if you like high tension strings.
Yeah, but a lot of times people will try high tension strings and not be set up for high tension strings.
Oh, and so that's true. Yeah.
Like when it makes playing like harder, then it kind of negates whatever tonal quality it brings to the table. Mm-hmm. So you kind of have to pair it with the right setup too.
Oh yeah, and that's where we come in. Thank you.
hard song to play on soprano. Playing like, what is it again?
I know, actually, I had to look the whole time. I was like, oh.
It still sounds like as loud as it, the bigger sizes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Part of that is just Koloha. Part of that is, I don't know. They just, this series sounds amazing. I actually really love Mango pairing with Koloha because they're such a bold, bright sound. It kind of warms it up a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we're not sure how many of these they're going to make, but they made a run of these Royal Picaques, which have that more elegant-looking ebony headstock and that crown-style end of the fretboard, a version of it similar to before. I think a little bit more tasty. Yeah. Boy, these sound good. I don't know.
Very guys, nice and pungent.
You guys can ask Paul why they sound so good.
He'd just be like, it's just what we do.
Yeah.
And because they sound so good, they're easy to sell, too.
Yeah, like, yeah. You work up at the store all the time, yeah. So people get to come in and actually play and hear all of these beyond, like, video sound samples and stuff. And
yeah.
Kolohas are quite nice to have in the shop.
Yeah, I mean, like, when you see their eyes light up when you they go from like a less expensive import model to something that's made on island, especially like a Koloha, they're like, whoa, I didn't, you know, they didn't never would expect so much sound and tone to come out from a tiny instrument, which is, I think that's like one of the most fun parts about working in this store and helping customers decide on their next ukulele or their first. But yeah, I would say that this line, two thumbs up.
Thumbs up from Clay.
Two thumbs up from me.
Yeah. All right, four thumbs up. Six thumbs up. So
include my two thumbs on my toes, my big toes.
We had a canceled order for a singer that had some of Joel's Logic High Tension installed. With the low G, and I played it and I was like, oh my gosh, this is like perfect pairing for mm-hmm. this instrument. Like it just kind of like filled it out, warmed it up, still had all of that body and richness, but it made me want to put that set on one of the Maoloas too that came in. So we're going to end this out with those two instruments. So yeah. play. Give us a sound sample of this new Singer model.
Yeah.
This is the RT5-CS
Cherry Sunburst.
And this one has the Uke Logic Hard Tension Low G set.
Yeah. This currently is my go-to strings for most of my ukuleles. Because these are braced like more on the traditional fan bracing. The Uke Logics really help bring out like a little bit more warmth. Actually, not just a little bit, a lot more.
It's a lot of volume.
Yeah, a lot of body.
Yeah. Okay, so Corey, give us a sound sample on the Maloa TT80CW with the Uke Logic Hard Tension Low G set. Yeah, so that's like the top end of the Mauloa line with the abalone around the top and the scoop cutaway, all solid acacia, and with the Ucologic hard tension low G set really brings out that richness, that fullness.
Yeah.
And for these sell for $749 with kind of a nice padded gig bag, but can get them with a Wahoo case that fits perfectly. Quite the value. And we love you guys, and we will see you next week. Aloha.